Hey everybody, welcome to this week's coloring stream. My name's Andy, and I'll be here for the next couple hours coloring all the drawings I did this week. My regular stream is Draw Something, which I do on Wednesdays at 7 p.m. Pacific. And so I usually, you know, I do all the drawings on that stream, and then on Saturdays at 1 p.m. Pacific, like right around this time, I color them all live on stream, which is what I'm doing right now. So let's get started here. I got 9 drawings to color today, so quite a big load. And the theme was dogs. It was a dog theme. Starting things off, we have a guy who's at the dentist, and he's having mouth pain caused by his canine teeth, which are literally canine teeth. You got dogs' teeth with dog faces on them, and they're growling and nudging against the teeth next to them. It looks very uncomfortable. So I'm just gonna get started here with the coloring. Thank you. think that'll do it for this one. Pretty basic, but it works. I'll go ahead and bring up a close-up view. To drawing number two. Alright, this one's a little more complex. So a running joke that used to be on this show a long time ago, like several months ago, like back when I was first starting streaming, was I would get requests to draw a corgi, do a drawing with a corgi and a Butterfinger, some kind of Butterfinger thing. It could be a Butterfinger mirror ball, or Butterfinger meteor, or a Butterfinger skull. Here I chose a here I drew a a corgi holding a Butterfinger foam finger, a Butterfinger finger per se. Cheering on wet food as it fights against dry dog food. Wet dog food and dry dog food are having a battle with each other, and a corgi is cheering on wet food you. There's a guy next to him who's rooting for dry food state, who's obviously looking a little less enthused about the situation. Now, of course, we have an announcer dog with a press hat on. Wet spreads a steady jet, but dry remains solid and steadfast. So, yeah, that pretty much covers it. Wet food is spraying its juices, but dry food is solid and sturdy, so he's holding his ground against it. Started here. Island Vibing, welcome. Nope, haven't gotten to that one yet. That's, boy, how far down the line is that? Got 9 drawings in total to color. I think that one's pretty close to the end of the list, but since you're here, I'll, push it up so I do it next. Or maybe even do it right now if you, oh, hold on a second. Oh, yeah, it's, drawing, it's number 6 out of 9, so, if you're probably tight on time, I can go ahead and do that one now while you're here watching. Come back to this one. Because you never know how long these drawings can take to color. I don't want to keep you waiting for too long. And that was a drawing I was using for a reference to get the corgi color right. Okay, Island, thank you. You're puttering? What do you mean by that? Yeah, it's, I was gonna say it's a good day for it, but, I don't know how different your weather is than my weather. I'm in Eastern Washington State. I don't know where you live. But where I am right now, it's, 74 degrees and partly cloudy. But it's pretty nice. Maine, okay. I have not been to Maine yet. The only place on the east coast of the U.S. that I've been to is, Massachusetts, and that was 17 years ago for a family reunion in, Plymouth, just outside of Boston. Island, since you're, I don't know if you were here when I drew this. I know you popped in on the drawing stream last Wednesday, but I know you, had to leave at some point, so this might have been after you left. This is a, corgi with a Butterfinger foam finger. It's a foam finger made out of Butterfinger, so it's chocolate covering, crispy peanut butter. He's, rooting, he's, cheering on at this, one-on-one match between wet dog food and dry dog food. So, he's cheering for Wet Food U, Wet Food University. The dog next to him is cheering for Dry Food State. And it looks like the, wet food and the dry food are kind of equally matched, but it's only a matter of time before the, odds lean in one or the other's favor. But yeah, just so you know what I'm, working on here. Make that a little bit darker. Okay. It's a little too dark to see the text. I'm going to change that color. Just gotta figure out what the background color for this is gonna be. I was thinking somewhere in the reddish-orange range to kind of, you know, heighten the intensity.
Thank you.
The only thing I'm concerned about is that maybe there's too much orange and too much orange slash red on the screen here. There's, like, most of the drawing is that. Maybe I'll go back and make changes to it later. But for right now, I think I like it fine. So we go ahead and bring up the close-up view. Island, that's a good point. Thank you. Save it one more time, just to be safe. What do we got up next? Okay, another simple drawing here. This one's cute. I kind of played with the idea that dominoes are often referred to as bones. You know, dominoes, tiles, you know, even like Mahjong tiles and Mahjong. That was redundant. I refer to his bones, so he's got a bone in his mouth, but he's tipping over other bones like dominoes. Gonna go ahead and color this red with white dots, because this sounds good. Tiny little gap is all it takes to get all the colors splurging all over the rest of the page. So fill that in. There we go. Thank you. Alright. No, I won't do that. This is one of those cases where I'm gonna go ahead and, I could do kind of a, you know, lighter green color around this. Yeah, that looks like it would work. Yeah, I think I like this. Yeah. I think that'll do. So, went from a fairly simple drawing to a really complex, pretty complex drawing to a really simple drawing. Thank you, Island. Thank you, Vibing. Want to be prepared in case Jason stops by and, you know, I say Island, that might get you too confused. Okay, so here is a drawing basically inspired by the phrase Dog Days of Summer, so... I actually got some help from one of my regular viewers, RoseRebel99, on this one. I wasn't really sure how to visualize Dog Days of Summer, and she said... Maybe have a dog in a pool, and the sun is blazing hot. So I kind of took that and created dogs in a swimming pool, and then the sun suddenly grows gigantic and evaporates all the water, and now he's just kind of in this empty pool like, oh. Well, that just happened. Yeah, might want to get inside, dog. So because the sun is so close, it's also going to be kind of taking its toll on the grass surrounding the pool. I was going to just give it a typical green grass color, but figured with the sun that close to it, it's going to be a little more dried out looking. Going to be more greenish brownish. Thank you. I'm gonna make this dog green because, I don't know, I mean, in this weird fantasy world, why not have dogs that go beyond the few real world colors dogs have? I'm kind of thinking of one of the books from my childhood, Go Dog Go, which had dogs of all different colors. So I'm thinking, having his feet start to turn red as they're being, actually, do I want to do that? I mean, that seems almost a little cruel. I mean, given that it's a cartoon, he'll recover from it quickly. Gotta fill in these little white spots. And that should do it. Bring up the close-up view. And it's been just over an hour since I started streaming, so I'm going to go ahead and take a stretch break. Time for some yoga poses. Also, hydrate. Ah. Let's see what we got next. Alright, here's one that I feel like is gonna be a lot easier to get once it's colored in. So, this dog comes across a forbidden sprinkler that he's supposed to... The sign says he cannot play in. But then he just ignores the sign because, whatever. And he plays around in it. Then the evil sprinkler goddess or something comes out of the shadows and transforms him into a sprinkler with her magic. And then the dog that was previously... This other dog that was turned into a sprinkler gets turned back into a regular dog. So it's kind of an endless cycle, like... And when another animal comes and plays in the forbidden sprinkler, the animal that was the forbidden sprinkler is set free, while the animal that was disobeying the rules is turned into a sprinkler. Yeah, it's a little weird. Thank you, Vibing. Really appreciate that. Yeah, I'm definitely a big fan of bright and vivid colors in my work. I mean, unless it fits more to have it be like, you know, more subdued and muted. But generally, I like to, you know, go bright and colorful. Thank you. I think I might actually need to redraw this here. This the thing is just standing above the grass. That's a little odd. I guess there's actually two ways I could handle this. I could either redraw this grass so that it's, you know, this thing's actually sitting on the grass, or I could have it, like, you know, draw some lines on it to indicate that it's levitating. I think I'm just gonna go ahead and redraw the grass. give the dog a significantly darker color palette, showing he's, you know, like being completely overshadowed by this sprinkler goddess. Alright, there we go. Think that'll do it? Go ahead and rig up the close-up view. This one more time, and Vibing, if you're still here, your drawing is up next. Here we have an island puppy cat, so it's a cross between a puppy and a cat. So you got dog ears, but it has cat eyes and cat whiskers, has a cat body, and it's also chewing on a foot, a human foot, sticking out of its mouth. And it has a sock on both of its ears, each of its ears. And of course, it's on an island because it was requested by Island Vibing Presents. So it seemed only appropriate to have it on an island. So Vibing, what colors does Mo have, or what are his fur? What is his fur color? Is it brown? Is it orange? Is it like really light yellow? Brown and blacks. Good to know. Oh. I was just kind of looking like a brown bumblebee with the stripes. And what color are Mo's eyes, by the way? Are they blue or green? Green, yellow, okay. Put some classic gray and white socks on her ears. Alright. rest of the socks are very light gray. Oh, vibing, that's awesome. Thank you. I think Mo's pretty much done. Here's the close-up view. Thanks so much, vibing. Looks like there's one little spot I forgot to fill in. There we go. Alright, that just leaves three more drawings to go. Vibing, thanks so much for hanging around and waiting until I got to that drawing. I really appreciate it. If you want to take off and go do something else, just yeah, it's totally fine. And I think I just heard the cheer sound. 100 bits! Thanks so much, Vibing! Alright, so this next drawing here is, it's a pizza chef dog. It's a dog in a pizza kitchen who, uses his paws, he walks around in circles, as dogs often do, to, spread the dough out and flatten it. But then he instinctively just lies down and takes a nap, and then his boss walks in and sees him napping and goes... clearly not happy with the situation. Alright, Vibing, if you're gonna head out, have a great rest of your day. I'll see you around. I may not be doing any streaming this next week. I'm going to be getting ready for Father's Day. I'm going to make my dad a Father's Day card. So, drawing is not going to be... I'm going to be taking the week off from drawing again, I think. Maybe I'll still do a gaming stream. I don't know. We'll see. But this could be my last stream for a little while, so... I'll see you around. Maybe I'll see you on another channel, or I'll pop in on your channel. So, of course, he's putting on, like, protective gloves before he starts putting his paws all over the pizza dough, because, you know, health safety. Once again, I'm being really indecisive with background color. think this one's good. So I'll just go ahead and bring up the close-up view. That means there's two more to go. All right, next up we got a drawing based on the phrase, the phrase puppy love. So we got a boy puppy and a girl puppy, you know, giving themselves lovey-dovey eyes, and there's hearts on either side. You know, the girl dog is having hearts that look like the boy dog, and the boy dog is having hearts that look like the girl dog. It's just overall cute. Alright, it just hit 3 o'clock where I am. It's been 2 hours since I started the stream. I'm gonna go ahead and take another stretch break. So, here we go. More yoga. Thank you. Alright, I think that'll probably do it for this one. Save. Bring the close-up view. Alright. Got one more drawing left for today, and it is... two dogs robbing a bank. A New York City bank, to be specific. So, pretty self-explanatory. There's the big one and the small one, or the big, bulky one and the small, skinny one. The big, bulky one's carrying several little bags. The skinny one's, of course, carrying one giant bag that he can barely hold up. No doubt, you know, he was saddled with that by the big one, who's probably in charge. Sorry, I'm doing kind of a funny thing here where the, this big dog's hat is the same color as this little dog's fur, and his hat is the same color as the big dog's fur. Just kind of a cute little detail in there. Thank you. Alright. Let me just see how I feel about this. I think I feel good about this. So I'll go ahead and save it. Bring up the close-up view. Kind of did something a little more stylized there with the sky color and the skyline of buildings. Could have just gone with the traditional, you know, blue sky or even, you know, an orange evening or morning sky, but wanted to go a slightly different direction, but I think it looks pretty good. And that is it for this week's batch of drawings. I guess I'll go back to the close-up view so I can do a quick recap before I raid out. So here's the two dogs robbing the New York City bank. Let's save it one more time just to be safe. Alright, I'm gonna head back to the beginning here. Alright, here we started off the stream by coloring this one. It's the, it's a guy who's having mouth pain. He's got a toothache. Turns out it's because of his canines. His canine teeth are, growling and grinding up against the teeth next to them, or whatever these teeth are called. I'm not a dental expert. I don't remember exactly what these teeth are referred to as. But yeah, basically, they're causing a lot of trouble. Alright, next up, we got a corgi with a Butterfinger number one finger cheering on his wet dog food, as it's in a battle against dry dog food. The dog next to him is wearing a shirt for dry food state, so obviously he's rooting for this guy. And then you got the fast-talking announcer with a press hat and an old-fashioned, old-timey microphone. And yeah, that pretty much sums it up. Tasty feast, Rowdy's dog food. Wet food you. Alright, and next up we got a very simple drawing, just a dog holding a domino, which dominoes are, you know, sometimes referred to as bones, and then he's also knocking over a row of bones like dominoes. And yeah, that covers it. Next, we got a Dog Days of Summer. The sun is ridiculously huge, and it evaporated all the water from the dog's pool. And his feet are starting to burn, as you can see on the super hot bottom of the pool. He needs to get inside and quick. And I even made the grass look extra dried out because the sun is so close to it. Next up, we got a dog who learns a lesson the hard way. He's told by the sign to not play in the sprinkler. It's forbidden, but he does it anyway. And then this sprinkler goddess comes out of the shadows and transforms him into a sprinkler. And then the sprinkler ends up getting turned back into a dog, and he's finally free again, and will be until some other disobedient animal comes and plays in the sprinkler, and then they're gonna get cursed. It's just a never-ending cycle. And here we go for Island Vibing Presents. It's a puppy cat. It's her puppy cat, Mo. Black and brown striped. Likes socks and feet, so she's chewing human foot in her mouth and has socks on both of her ears. And then I put her on an island because, well, Island Vibing Presents requested it and I thought it would be only appropriate. And here we have a dog food chef, pizza chef dog working in the kitchen. He's walks around in circles on the dough to flatten it out and spread it out into a circle. But then he instinctively lays down and takes a nap, and then his boss comes in and looks pretty unhappy about that. And finally, we have Puppy Love. Boy puppy, girl puppy, they're giving themselves the lovey-dovey eyes. And you can see on either side of the, there's hearts that have the girl dog's face and the boy dog's face. And yeah, I like how this turned out with all the colors, various shades of red and pink. So yeah, without any further ado, I'm gonna go ahead and rate us out. Looks like, let's see, Dreamer Seeker is live with Pokemon Legends Arceus. Mini Moon P is also live. I've rated her several times. I'm gonna go ahead and rate Dreamer Seeker. She's usually not live around this time, so I'm gonna go ahead and give her a visit here. So let's head over there. Have a great rest of your weekend, guys. Like I said, I don't think I'm gonna be streaming again this week. We'll see, though. I'm gonna be working on Father's Day stuff. So yeah, we'll see what happens. I will be letting you guys know on my Discord. Let me get the link for that up here. There's the link for my Discord. Click on it and you can be invited in. So I'll let anyone know, everyone in my Discord know if I'm planning on doing a stream. But for now, I'm going to go ahead and raid Dreamer. So have a great rest of your weekend, everyone. Take care.